To date, I have recorded nearly 350 podcast episodes since 2015. I started podcasting when a lot of people didn't even know what a podcast was. My podcast, the YouTube Power Hour podcast, has been featured as a top marketing podcast on iTunes for the last several years. And I've also been interviewed by over a dozen popular podcasts, such as Smart Passive Income with Pat Flynn, Mind Your Business with James Wedmore, and a lot more. And I've also been a featured speaker at Podcast Movement, where I spoke about branding and growing a podcast. So let's just say that I know a thing or two about podcasting. I also happen to know a lot about YouTube. I've been running my YouTube bootcamp, coaching YouTube creators, and managing YouTube channels for businesses since 2018. And today, I've coached over 700 female YouTube creators and personally ran dozens of channels with my strategic channel management agency. So I also know a thing or two about YouTube, which gives me an interesting perspective when it comes to speaking about both starting a podcast and or a YouTube channel. And in this video, I'm gonna weigh the pros and cons of both podcasting and YouTube, and if you should do one or the other, both, or maybe neither. And I'm gonna reveal my opinions based off of doing this for years and years, seeing the industry inside and out, and if I think it's worth your time. Keep in mind, this is just my opinion. You know, it's not an absolute answer. If you love podcasting, want to podcast, great. If you love YouTube and want to do YouTube, great. This is just my thoughts and experiences. And by the way, my name is Erica Vieira, and if you're new here, make sure you subscribe because I upload videos about YouTube growth and success, and I interview some amazing female online content creators as well. So I'm gonna get started with talking about podcasting, and we'll get into the pros of podcasting and the cons, and also how that compares against YouTube. So when it comes to a podcast, one of the big pros is that it's a lot easier to get started as a podcaster versus a YouTube channel. And the reason why it's so much easier to get started podcasting is because it just doesn't require as much technological knowledge as something with video. For me, when I started my podcast, I needed something that was a little bit more flexible, and I didn't really have the time to learn video editing and do all those things that's required of having a successful YouTube channel. And you know, for me, I was pregnant, having babies, breastfeeding, all the things that come along with being a new mom, and podcasting for me fit my lifestyle better because there just wasn't as much tech involved. It was a lot easier to learn how to podcast versus all the tech involved with starting a YouTube channel. So in that way, it is a big pro. Another pro that's related to that is that it's easier to create content as a podcast versus a YouTube channel. Simply recording your voice is infinitely times easier than also videoing yourself as well. You don't have to worry about editing the video footage. You just need to focus on the audio, and you don't have to worry about shooting B-roll or the lighting. As a woman, one thing that takes a lot of time is getting ready and making sure that you look presentable. And with a podcast, you really don't have to worry about that at all, which is really, really nice. You can record a podcast in your pajamas, rolling out of bed. You could record a podcast at any time of the day. You don't have to worry about lighting. Like right now, I'm filming this because the lighting is perfect, and I can only film during certain hours of the day because of the lighting. And also because I need a certain room in order for me to film. But when it comes to podcasting, when I was doing just my podcast, I would literally film in bed sometimes. I would also film while I was breastfeeding. I'm telling you, it's very versatile to be able to record a podcast, especially the podcast where I wasn't interviewing somebody. That does require a little bit more planning, but even then, that's a lot easier than including videos with your interviews, which I've done both, where I did just podcasts and audio only interviews and with video. And I have to tell you, it's a lot more work and planning when you're including the video as well. And another pro, which I kind of touched on, is the fact that you don't have to show your face. So for a lot of people, one of the things that stops them from getting onto YouTube is this camera fear. And I actually have a whole video on how to combat that if you are camera shy, and I would definitely recommend checking that out. It's a great video and some really good tips. But for some people, that holds them back from starting a YouTube channel or being on YouTube. And being a podcaster and creating a podcast, eliminates that completely because you're not showing your face at all. You don't have to worry about the way you look. You don't have to worry about getting presentable. In that way, it's a little bit easier and definitely a pro in my eyes. Another pro about podcasting is that you really are able to create a deep connection with your listeners. Listening to a podcast is a very intimate experience. I know that from experience of listening to podcasts and also being a podcaster myself. People do get very connected to you, and it's a great way to establish a relationship with your audience. And in that way, I do think podcasting is a pro versus, say, even like Instagram or other social sites. I do think YouTube, you also can create that really close connection. But with podcasting, you can create that deep connection without having to deal with the whole production of video. Having somebody in your ear and like listening to them and for an hour on end or maybe an hour a week really creates that bond between you and your audience, and it is a very intimate experience. There's a lot of pros to having a podcast and starting a podcast, but there are some cons, which I'm going to go over right now. So one of the biggest cons for podcasting in my experience, and also my experience of being in the industry of knowing a lot of podcasters and seeing a lot of podcasters come and go. Like, I've been doing it since 2015. So I've been pretty consistent for a very long time. I've seen a lot of people start podcasts after me and end their podcasts, in a short period of time. And part of the reason I believe is that it's much, much more difficult to grow an audience as a podcaster, because there's not an algorithm pushing it out like there is on YouTube or TikTok or some of the other social platforms. With podcasting, you're really relying on the iTunes search engine. It's not nearly as good as the YouTube algorithm and the Google search engine. And then you're also just relying on people finding you that way, or somehow browsing all through all the different podcasts in iTunes or the different podcasting platforms that they use to listen. So it's a lot harder to get discovered through podcasts. And I can do a whole video on how to get discovered as a podcaster, because I have a lot of experience with that. If you do want that and you want me to talk a little bit about that, I'm more than happy to do a video on that. Just let me know in the comments. But for the most part, you know, it's more difficult, because with a podcast, you can't necessarily upload a podcast episode and it go viral and overnight you now have this huge audience. Whereas with YouTube, that is definitely a possibility. It happens day in and day out. I see it happening all the time. You can be a nobody and have no audience at all, but you can upload a couple videos that are trending or that get picked up by the algorithm, and boom, overnight you've got, 10,000 subscribers sometimes. With podcasting, it doesn't happen like that. It's impossible to go viral as a podcast, and therefore, because of that, it's a lot more difficult to grow your audience. Another con with podcasting is that the engagement isn't the same as some of the other social platforms like YouTube, like Instagram, or even TikTok, because with podcasting, you're just listening. There's no platform for you to comment. Yes, you can leave a review, but it's nearly impossible to get people to leave reviews, let me tell you. Like, if you want to leave a review for my podcast, then definitely feel free to do so. But it's not something that a lot of people do or instinctively do like they do with YouTube comments. YouTube comments is a very natural, instinctive thing. A lot of people like to share their thoughts, and there's no place for podcast listeners to be able to share their thoughts on what they're listening about. Therefore, that's why a lot of podcasters have Instagram accounts or even Facebook groups. I know myself, I had a Facebook group when I first started my podcast, because I realized I didn't have anywhere to interact with the listeners of my show. And a Facebook group was a great place to do that. Same thing with Instagram. So that is a big con of podcasting. Another con with podcasting is that I believe that you can make more money with affiliates with other platforms like Instagram and YouTube, because you have links right there in the description or in a swipe up. Well, now they got rid of swipe up. It's like a little sticker thing. But there's easier ways to make affiliate money through YouTube and other platforms. Whereas podcasting, you really are relying on either selling your own product, which is what I've done and been very successful at, and also sponsorships. And then we're kind of losing that affiliate income stream, because it's just a lot more difficult because where are people gonna click, right? Where are people gonna click to buy that product? You have to give them a code and they have to go directly onto the website, and they'll have to look at get the notes inside of their podcast app, and all this is just not as intuitive as just a YouTube video and the description box of a YouTube video. So next I'm going to talk about YouTube specifically. A lot of the points I already discussed, so I won't go into detail, but the first pro about YouTube is that it is a very, very powerful algorithm, and it's a search engine owned by Google, and because of that, the discoverability there is so much higher than I believe any other platform. You can literally go viral overnight. And because of that, all the work that you put into YouTube really can pay off. Although in my experience and opinion, having a YouTube channel is a lot more work than a podcast, the opportunity to grow is much, much greater with a YouTube channel than a podcast. Also with YouTube channel, another pro is that you can have a little bit more variety of content because you have this visual medium. So you can express visually different types of things, whereas with a podcast, it's really limited to just you talking or interviews, which isn't bad, but if you're somebody that wants to do something beyond that or something visual, then it's a no-brainer to go into video and YouTube versus podcasting. And another pro, which I mentioned earlier, is that there is a really big community aspect with engagement when it comes to YouTube. There's the comments and the community tab. There's all these different elements within YouTube that really promote and foster a community, whereas podcasting just doesn't have that. So as a YouTuber with a YouTube channel, you don't need to create a Facebook group. You don't need to be on another platform to have that engagement. Whereas with podcasting, I do believe that if you do have a podcast, you do need to have some other platform so you have some way to communicate directly with your audience. So with YouTube, the big con with YouTube, and I think this is across the board comparing it to every other platform there is that YouTube is a lot more difficult as a platform in general to create the content, and it's just a lot more work. Creating good quality video takes a lot of time. It's a production. I mean, it's everything from the lighting to the sound to the editing to what you're saying, the content itself. All of it adds up to a lot of work, and in my experience and opinion, a lot more work than creating podcast content. And so you have to be up for the challenge of A, learning all the different aspects of being successful on YouTube, and B, the time it takes to actually create good content. So I would say that is a huge, huge con of YouTube. But in my experience, working with YouTubers, running channels, for a lot of people, that work is worth it because the end result can be huge and life-changing and really establish a very, very large audience. And so there are the pros and the cons of podcasting versus YouTube. And my question to you is, have you considered starting a podcast? Part of the reason why I created this video is because I get a lot of people in my boot camp and people that I work with thinking that starting a podcast is gonna be a great idea. You have to be just very realistic about the fact that a podcast isn't gonna help you grow your audience anymore. It can help establish a deeper connection with the existing audience that you have, and that's part of the reason why you see so many celebrities creating podcasts, or you actually see very large YouTube creators now deciding to start a podcast, because the content is much, in my opinion, this isn't, I don't know this for a fact, but in my opinion, the content is so much easier to create. And if you're a YouTuber who's creating a ton of content all the time, you might be able to take a step back, maybe create a little less YouTube content and go onto a podcast because you've already grown your audience to say a million subscribers, right? So it's a great platform if you already have a large platform somewhere else. And so if you have any questions about podcasting, let me know in the comments. I don't talk a lot about it here on the channel, but it's something I do know a lot about. And if you want me to create more videos about it, I'd be more than happy to do so. And if you like this video, give it a like and make sure you subscribe. Mwah.